Hello friends, welcome to another lecture of machine design, and in today's lecture we are going to cover design of welded joints. Those of you who are coming onto this channel for the first time, let me introduce my team. Unacademy Gate ME. This is India's only YouTube channel right now which is dedicated completely to mechanical engineering students. ये इकलौता चैनल है आज की डेट में जहां सिर्फ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग से रिलेटेड लाइव सेशंस लिए जाते हैं, लाइव लेक्चर्स लिए जाते हैं और मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग से रिलेटेड बाकी के वीडियोस भी पोस्ट किए जाते हैं. एंड दिस इज माय टीम ऑफ अन अकेडमी गेट एमई व्हिच कंसिस्ट ऑफ सम ऑफ द फाइनेस्ट टीचर्स ऑफ इंडिया. सो डोंट फॉरगेट टू क्विकली सब्सक्राइब टू दिस चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन. सब्सक्राइब करना और बेल आइकन दबाना ना भूले ताकि आपको सारे पोस्ट की अपडेट मिलते रहे, नोटिफिकेशन मिलते रहे. एंड माय फ्रेंड्स, इन ऑर्डर टू ग्रो इन नंबर्स एंड इन ऑर्डर टू रीच टू मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स, वी नीड योर सपोर्ट. चूंकि ये वीडियोस कंप्लीटली फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट है, कोई इसमें कॉस्टिंग नहीं है, कोई आपको सब्सक्रिप्शन लेने की जरूरत नहीं है, तो प्लीज हमें बाकी के स्टूडेंट्स तक पहुंचने में हेल्प कीजिए, सपोर्ट कीजिए बाय शेयरिंग द लिंक ऑफ आर वीडियोस ऑन योर व्हाट्सएप एंड फेसबुक. इफ यू डू दैट यू विल बी सपोर्टिंग अस टू मेक मोर एंड मोर कंटेंट. आप जितना ज्यादा सपोर्ट करेंगे आपको उतना ही ज्यादा कंटेंट देखने को मिलेगा. वॉचिंग मी फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ. माई नेम इज अपरूप राव, M.Tech from IIT Kharagpur, and my specialization was mechanical systems design. Then my friend, I was recruited by Mahindra Research Valley, which is the research and development center of Mahindra and Mahindra cars and tractors. The cars and tractors of Mahindra are designed there. Some of the finest SUVs, XUV 500, TUV, KUV, all these are designed at Mahindra Research Valley. So I worked there for 2 years as deputy manager, and my work was related to the design and analysis of the body parts of a car. Then I quit my job because I always wanted to teach, so I started teaching. I've been teaching for more than 6 years now. I've taught thousands of students all across India, and I teach subjects related to design, strength of materials, machine design, engineering mechanics, theory of machines. मेरा हमेशा से ही teaching में passion रहा है. और आप देख सकते हैं कि मेरा जो रेलेवेंट एक्सपीरियंस रहा है, वो मेरा पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन हो आईआईटी में या वो मेरा 2 साल का एक्सपीरियंस हो महिंद्रा में, इट इज रिलेटेड टू डिजाइन. तो इसीलिए मैं डिजाइन से रिलेटेड सब्जेक्ट से ही डील करता हूँ. ओके, सो हियर वी आर स्टडिंग मशीन डिजाइन. हमने अब तक काफी चैप्टर्स कवर किए हुए हैं. टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर डिजाइन ऑफ वेल्डेड जॉइंट्स. ओके, सो लेट्स फर्स्ट डिस्कस what are welded joints. So we all know what is welding, right? Welding is a process of joining two elements by means of heat, right? Heat apply करके हम दो elements को आपस में जोड़ते हैं, fuse करते हैं, right? Now welded joints are permanent joints. अब permanent और temporary joints क्या होता है, दोनों में क्या difference है? अगर मान लो for example आप दो plates को जोड़ रहे हो, okay? Let's say you are joining two plates, okay? Afterwards, if you want to remove that joint and there is no damage to the material, then it is known as a temporary joint. If you can remove a joint without damage, it is a temporary joint. Agar bina damage kiye aap dono elements ko remove kar sakte, disconnect kar sakte, alag kar sakte, then it is called a temporary joint. For example, क्या एग्जाम्पल हो सकता है, व्हाट कैन बी एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ टेम्पररी जॉइंट? नट एंड बोल्ट जॉइंट, माय फ्रेंड, नट एंड बोल्ट जॉइंट. सो इन केस ऑफ नट एंड बोल्ट जॉइंट, व्हाट डू? वी जॉइन टू प्लेट्स यूजिंग बोल्ट एंड नट, राइट? एंड इफ यू वांट टू डिस्कनेक्ट देम, सेपरेट देम, देन यू जस्ट रिमूव द नट. सो देयर इज नो डैमेज टू द मटेरियल. सो नट एंड बोल्ट जॉइंट इज अ टेम्पररी जॉइंट. बट इफ there is some damage to the material while separating the elements, if there is some damage to the material, then it is called a permanent joint. And what are the examples of permanent joint? Welded joints and riveted joints. Welded joints and riveted joints both are परमानेंट ज्वाइंट, ये दोनों परमानेंट ज्वाइंट है। क्यों परमानेंट ज्वाइंट है? क्योंकि अगर आप एलिमेंट्स को सेपरेट करना चाहते हैं तो आपको वहां मटेरियल को डैमेज करना पड़ेगा, कुछ ना कुछ डैमेज होगा, सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज अ परमानेंट ज्वाइंट। सो डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन परमानेंट एंड टेम्पररी ज्वाइंट? बोल्ट ज्वाइंट इज अ टेम्पररी ज्वाइंट, वेल्डेड एंड रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट्स आर परमानेंट ज्वाइंट। ओके, रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट यू माइट हैव सीन, रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट यू माइट हैव सीन, इट लुक्स समथिंग लाइक दिस। ओके, इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट डू आई मीन बाय रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट, लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जांपल, इट लुक्स समथिंग लाइक दिस। ओके, लेट्स से वी हैव टू प्लेट्स, लेट्स से दिस इज वन प्लेट एंड दिस इज अनदर प्लेट, ओके, ओवरलैपिंग ईच अदर। सो रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट जो है वो कुछ ऐसा दिखता है, रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट लुक्स समथिंग लाइक दिस। ओके, बीच में एक ऐसा रिवेट होता है। यू माइट हैव सीन दिस इन योर होम ऑल्सो, यू माइट हैव सीन दिस इन योर होम ऑल्सो। बाल्टी कभी देखी आपने? बाल्टी, बाल्टी का जो सीम होता है वो रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट से कनेक्ट होता है। सो दिस इज अ रिवेट, ओके, दिस इज अ रिवेट, ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो अ परमानेंट ज्वाइंट, बिकॉज इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेपरेट दीज प्लेट्स यू हैव टू ब्रेक दिस रिवेट। Okay, you have to break this rivet. This rivet is nothing like a nail. Okay, it is nothing like a nail. Okay, so if these are two plates, we first make a hole and we put a rivet inside the hole and then we close the head. Okay, then we close the ends of the rivet like this. Okay, so this end is closed. This end is also closed. So if you want to separate the plates, you have to break this rivet, then only it will be separated. Okay, so this is a riveted joint. So do you understand this? Do you understand this, my friend? Okay, very good. If you understand this, very good. So this is also a permanent joint. Okay, now my friends, what is the advantage of welded joint? What is the function of welded joint? Where it is used? वेल्डेड जॉइंट्स आर मोस्टली यूज्ड इन फैब्रिकेशन, ओके, स्टील फैब्रिकेशन जहां होता है वहां पे वेल्डेड जॉइंट हम यूज करते हैं एज एन अल्टरनेटिव टू कास्टिंग एंड फोर्जिंग। समटाइम्स कास्टिंग एंड फोर्जिंग आर नॉट फीजिबल और दे आर नॉट इकोनॉमिकल, सो इन दैट केस माई फ्रेंड्स वी यूज वेल्डिंग। ओके, लेट्स से यू वॉन्ट टू मेक अ सिंगल एलिमेंट, ओके, बाय कास्टिंग प्रोसेस इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल, सो वॉट यू विल डू, यू विल जॉइन डिफरेंट different separate parts for making a single body. Okay, you will join separate parts for making a single body using welding, my friends. Okay, so fabrication mein mostly it is used, but it is also used in some other applications. For example, it is used as a repair tool. Okay, sometimes for let's say your element has developed a crack, okay, and you want to repair the element, then also welding is used. Okay, so welding is used in other applications also, but mostly it is used in fabrication. Okay, angle plate, channel plate, ये सब जो बनती है जहाँ पे fabrication जहाँ पे होता है वहाँ welding को हम use करते हैं. Okay, compared to riveted joints, what are the advantages? Compared to riveted joint is also a permanent joint. Okay, welded joint, riveted joint, they both are rivals. Okay, welded joint और riveted joint एक दूसरे के दुश्मन है, समझ लो, क्योंकि दोनों जो है वो एक ही टाइप के एप्लीकेशन में यूज किए जा सकते हैं. जहां पे भी आपको परमानेंट ज्वाइंट चाहिए वहां यू कैन यूज वेल्डेड और रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट. ओके, सो वेल्ड रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट से कंपेयर करें देन व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ वेल्डेड ज्वाइंट्स? वेल्डेड ज्वाइंट्स आर माय फ्रेंड चीपर एंड लाइटर. एक तो इनकी कॉस्ट कम होती है, द कॉस्ट ऑफ वेल्डेड ज्वाइंट्स आर लेस कंपेयर्ड टू रिवेटेड ज्वाइंट, एंड सेकेंड वेट एडिशन विच इज द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम इन केस ऑफ ज्वाइनिंग प्रोसेस. ज्वाइनिंग प्रोसेस जहां भी होती है वेट एडिशन इज अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट एड अ लॉट ऑफ वेट. ओके, यू कैन नॉट एड अ लॉट ऑफ वेट. ओके, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ज्वाइन टू पार्ट्स यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट द वेट एडिशन इज एज लेस एज पॉसिबल. यू कैन नॉट एड अ लॉट ऑफ वेट टू द मशीन पार्ट. ओके, अदरवाइज वॉट विल हैपन, इट विल इंक्रीज द ओवरऑल वेट ऑफ द बॉडी. ओके, लेट्स से यू आर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग अ कार, so if you are adding a lot of weight the car will become very heavy. Okay, so we don't want that, that's why we use welding instead of riveting, because riveting weighs more than welding. Rivet joint mein jo rivet ka weight hota hai wo extra add hota hai, तो उसकी वजह से रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स का वेट जो है वेल्डेड जॉइंट के कंपैरिजन में ज्यादा होता है. वेल्डिंग में वेट एडिशन जो है बहुत कम होता है. ओके, सो इट इज लेस कॉस्टली एंड वेट एडिशन इज ऑल्सो लेस कंपेयर टू रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स. माई फ्रेंड्स, रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स आर नाउअडेज रिप्लेस्ड बाय वेल्डेड जॉइंट. वेर एवर रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स वर यूज्ड, फॉर एग्जाम्पल बॉयलर्स, प्रेशर वेसल्स में रिवेटेड जॉइंट यूज होते थे, बॉयलर्स जो है उनमें रिवेटेड जॉइंट यूज होते थे, लेकिन आज की डेट में इनको रिप्लेस किया जा रहा है धीरे धीरे वेल्डेड जॉइंट से, बिकॉज वेल्डेड जॉइंट्स आर ऑलवेज मोर एडवांटेजियस कंपेयर टू रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई नाउअडेज स्लोली रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स आर बिकमिंग ऑब्सोलीट. वी डोंट वॉन्ट रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स, वेल्डेड जॉइंट्स आर ऑलवेज बेटर, वेल्डेड जॉइंट्स आर ऑलवेज प्रिफर्ड. ओके, नाउ माई फ्रेंड, we have to see what are the different types of welded joints. In order to see the design process, we need to first understand what are the different types of welded joint. Okay, so the two basic types of welded joints are butt joint and fillet joint. Okay, butt joint and fillet joint. So what is the difference between butt joint and fillet joint? A very simple and very easy difference between the two joints is, बट जॉइंट के केस में, इन केस ऑफ बट जॉइंट, लेट्स से यू आर जॉइनिंग टू प्लेट्स, प्लेट्स का एग्जाम्पल इज बेटर, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई ऑलवेज प्रेफर टू गिव द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ प्लेट्स इन केस ऑफ जॉइंट्स. ओके, सो लेट्स से यू हैव टू प्लेट्स, इफ बोथ द प्लेट्स आर केप्ट इन द सेम प्लेन, इफ बोथ द प्लेट्स आर केप्ट इन द सेम प्लेन, देन इट इज अ बट जॉइंट. ओके, इफ यू आर जॉइनिंग टू प्लेट्स एंड बोथ द प्लेट्स आर केप्ट इन द सेम प्लेन, दोनों का प्लेन सेम है, then it is a butt joint. But if the planes are different, if they are overlapping each other, if the planes are different, upar niche rakha hua hai aur overlap kar raha hai, then it is a fillet joint. Do you understand the difference? Do you understand this difference, my friend? If the plates are kept in the same plane, butt joint. Different plane and overlapping, fillet joint. There is no overlapping in case of butt joint. There is no overlapping in case of butt joint because they are kept in the same plane. They cannot overlap each other. But in case of fillet joint, they are kept on one on top of each other. So, there is some overlapping. Okay? So, this is the difference between butt joint and fillet joint. Let me draw the butt joint for you. Okay? Let me draw the butt joint for you so that you will be able to understand better. Okay? So, ek chota sa main drawing banaunga. Let's say this is one plate. Okay, I am taking an example of plates. Okay, so this is one plate and this is another plate. Okay, now my friend, if you join these plates by welding like this. So now it has become a butt joint. Do you understand this? So you have two plates like this. ठीक है, दो plates है, same plane में रखी हुई है, दोनों का plane same है, कोई overlap नहीं हो रहा है, ऐसा side by side रखा है, the edges are touching each other. Okay, and you are joining this edge. ये जो edge है दोनों का, इस edge को अगर आप join कर रहे हैं, then it is a butt joint. Okay, so this was plate number one. This was plate number 2 and we joined both these plates. So this is a butt joint. Do you understand this much? Fillet joint ke case mein the plates will be overlapping each other. Now fillet joints are of two types, parallel and transverse. Okay, so let's understand the difference between parallel fillet and transverse fillet. Okay. So let me draw the plates again. Okay, let's say this is one plate. Okay, I will make the other plate shorter so that you will be able to understand better. Okay, I will make the other plate shorter like this. Okay, so you can see both the plates are overlapping each other like this, my friend. Let's say this is one plate. This is another plate. It is overlapping like this. Okay. So this is a case of fillet joint. Okay. So let me copy this because I will use this diagram for transverse fillet also. Okay, so let's say we have two cases. Okay, now my friend, let's say the load is applied in this direction. Let's say the load is acting like this. The load is acting like this. The load is acting like this. Okay. Now, in case of parallel fillet joint, the edges that are parallel to the load are welded. Okay. The load is acting in this direction, X direction. So, if you weld these parallel edges, then it will be a parallel fillet. See, these welds are parallel to the load. Okay. And if you weld the perpendicular edges, these vertical edges, like this. This edge and this edge will be a hidden edge. Samne se nahi dikhega, this will be a hidden edge. But this can also be welded like this. So this is a transverse fillet. Do you understand this difference, my friend? Very easy, very simple difference. The load is acting horizontally. Okay, right now, according to my drawing, the load is acting horizontally. So if the welds are horizontal, parallel fillet, because the welds are parallel to the load. And if the welds are perpendicular, transverse fillet. Now you must be thinking, why we need to divide them into parallel fillet and transverse fillet? Just because of this small difference, why do we need to divide them into different categories? We are putting them in different categories because the stresses developed in both the cases will be different. Because load ka direction jo hai plane ke saath different rahega in case of welded joint and in case of parallel and in case of transverse fillet, the direction of load with the weld plane will be different. So the stresses developed will be different. That's why we are putting them in different categories. Do you understand this simple logic, my friend? Why we are putting them in different categories? Because in case of parallel fillet, the stresses developed in the plane of weld will be different. In case of transverse fillet, the stresses developed in the plane of weld will be different because the angle between the load and the weld is different. That's why different joints, different fillet joints, parallel fillet, transverse fillet. Okay, so these are the three basic types. Okay, you can say butt joint, parallel fillet joint, transverse fillet joint. Okay, butt joint, parallel fillet joint, transverse fillet joint. Do you understand this? Now, my friend, in order to design these welded joints, what do we need to find? We need to find their strength. And what do we mean by strength? We need to find how much load you can apply on this joint. That is known as the strength. For any joint, this is very important thing to calculate. Kisi bhi joint ke liye zaruri kya hota hai, kya nikalna? Strength of that joint. Wo joint kitna force ya kitna load sustain kar sakta hai bina fail huye. That is the most important thing about any joint. Okay, in case of riveted joint, in case of bolted joint, in case of any type of joint, this is the most important thing to calculate. The strength of joint, how much load you can apply on the joint without causing failure. Failure bina cause kiye, failure bina huye, aap maximum kitna load utha sakte ho, 10 kilonewton, 20 kilonewton, 30 kilonewton, how much force you can apply here, that is the thing you need to calculate. Means you need to calculate the value of this P. You need to calculate the value of this force P that you can apply, maximum force that you can apply on this joint. Okay, so we will calculate the strength of each type of joint one by one. We will calculate the strength of butt joint, then parallel fillet joint, and then transverse fillet joint. So are you ready for this? If you are ready, hit the like button. If you have still not liked my video, nowadays I am seeing that if I'm not asking for you to like the video, you guys are not liking the video. That is not good, my friend. ये ज्यादती है हमारे साथ, ये अच्छी बात नहीं है. आपको बिना बोले वीडियोस को लाइक करना है, शेयर करना है, ठीक है? ये आपका फर्ज बनता है, क्योंकि अगर हम यहाँ इतनी मेहनत कर रहे हैं तो आपको भी थोड़ा सपोर्ट तो देना ही होगा. बिना आपके सपोर्ट के हम नहीं चल सकते. विदाउट योर सपोर्ट वी कांट डू दिस. ओके, सो वी वांट योर सपोर्ट, वी वांट योर कोऑपरेशन. एंड हाउ यू कैन सपोर्ट अस, हाउ यू कैन कोऑपरेट अस, फर्स्ट बाय लाइकिंग द वीडियो एंड सेकेंड बाय शेयरिंग द वीडियो. दीज आर द टू थिंग्स दैट यू कैन डू इन ऑर्डर टू सपोर्ट अस. एंड इफ यू सपोर्ट अस, देन वी विल बी एबल टू मेक a lot of content, my friend. We will be able to do a lot more on our YouTube channel. Okay, so for doing that, please support us by liking and sharing these videos. Thank you very much if you have already done that. Okay, so let's move on to the next topic, strength of butt joint. Okay, we have to find how much force you can apply on a butt joint without causing any failure, without causing any failure. Okay, so let's consider a butt joint. I will draw a butt joint now. Okay, so I will draw the plate and then I will draw the weld. Okay, look at the drawing process, my friend. Okay, okay, so these are the plates. Now I will draw the weld. So I will draw the weld using green color or blue color. Let's use the blue color. Okay, so the weld looks something like this. Okay, the weld looks something like this. थोड़ा उभरा हुआ रहेगा. Okay, protruded. It will be protruded from the surface. Okay, like this. Okay, it will be protruded from the surface like this. Can you see? So this is a butt joint. Okay, we have two plates kept in the same plane. Okay, two plates kept in the same plane, welded the edge. Okay, we have welded the edge. Okay, so this is a type of butt joint. Okay, now my friend, the load is acting like this. Let's say the force is acting like this. Okay, and we need to find how much maximum force you can apply. Let's say the maximum force that we can apply is P. Okay, how will you calculate it? First of all, let's define the dimensions. So let's say, sorry for that. Let's say this dimension is L. Okay, let's say this is the length of weld. Let's say this is the length of plate or length of weld. Okay, better length of weld. Okay, and my friend, let's say this is the thickness of plate. Okay, let's say this is the thickness of plate H. Sorry. Let's say this H is the thickness of plate. Okay. So L is length of weld. Okay, L is the length of weld. H is thickness of plate. Okay, h is the thickness of plate and this is the minimum thickness of weld, right? This is the minimum thickness of weld. Okay, this is the minimum thickness of weld. So this is known as throat of weld. Minimum thickness or you can call throat of weld, throat thickness. Minimum thickness is throat thickness. Okay, why minimum thickness, my friend? Understand this. Why minimum thickness? Understand this. The weld right now is like this. Sorry. Let me use the blue color because that is our color coding. So the weld is right now like this. The weld right now is like this. Right? The weld is like this. But this part, my friend, this part which is above and below the plates, okay, this extra material which is above and below the material below the plate, this extra material is known as reinforcement. Okay, this is known as reinforcement. This thing and this thing, they are known as reinforcement. Okay, they are known as reinforcement. And they are not considered. When we find the thickness of the weld, this reinforcement is not considered. Why we don't consider them? First reason is reinforcement is not a fixed thing. It varies. Okay, how much weld material you are pouring, that can vary, my friend. Let's say you are joining this plate and then there is another pair of plate. One pair of plate, another pair of plate. So in this pair of plate, the reinforcement will be different. In this case, it will be different, right? So you cannot keep a uniform thickness of reinforcement. This is the first reason. Second reason, in most of the cases, this reinforcement is removed. Okay. In most of the cases, what do we do? By grinding, this extra material is removed. Okay. So when we are finding the strength, when we are finding the strength of the joint, we don't consider this reinforcement. We will only consider this thickness. We will only consider the thickness of the plate. Okay. Jitna plate hai, sirf utna hi weld hum consider karenge. See, sirf utna hi weld hum consider karenge. Plate ke upar aur niche jo extra material hai, usko hum consider nahi karenge. It is called reinforcement. It is not considered in finding the strength of weld. Why? Because this reinforcement is in maximum cases removed by grinding or machining. We remove this reinforcement. Okay. So that's why we don't consider that. Okay. So this H is the thickness of plate, or it is also known as throat thickness of weld, minimum thickness of weld, throat thickness or minimum thickness of weld. Okay. Let's say that sigma max is maximum allowable stress of weld material, maximum allowable stress of weld material, and P is maximum allowable load, or you can call it strength, okay, on joint. Okay, so maximum, how much load we can apply on the joint? P. Okay, this is the maximum allowable load on the joint, my friend. Okay, all right. So now we need to find the value of P. So what will be the stress in the cross section of the weld? What will be the stress in the cross section of the weld? We are joining the two plates like this, right? And we are applying the load like this. Okay, so this load is normal to this cross section, right? This load P is normal to this cross section. What will be this cross section, my friend? Length is L and this thickness we are considering H. So my friend, maximum stress, sigma maximum will be equal to, in the cross section of weld, in the cross section, in the cross section of weld, sigma maximum will be equal to load upon area. And what is this area, my friend? What is the area of cross section? Length into thickness, H into L. Okay, thickness into length. So from here I can write like this, P equals to H into L into sigma maximum, which is what? Strength of the welded joint. It is the strength of the welded joint. Okay, it is the strength of the welded joint. Do you understand this much? Do you understand this much? Now my friend, it is not necessary that the load is always like this. The load can also be in different direction. For example, let's say the load is not acting normal to the cross section. Let's say this time the load is acting parallel to the cross section. Okay, let's say the load is acting like this. Okay, there is some arrangement and the load is acting like this. Okay, P, this is P and this is P. So in this case, what will be the strength, my friend? In this case, the load is parallel to the cross section. So which stress will be developed? Shear stress will be developed, right? So in this case, what will be your equation? Instead of sigma max, you will just have to write tau max. So your equation will become H into L multiplied by tau max. There is only one difference in this case and the last case. In the last case, the load was perpendicular to the cross section. In this case, the load is parallel to the cross section. Okay. So here, in this case, sigma max is developed. In this case, tau max is developed. So P will be equal to H into L into tau max. Very easy, very simple equation, right? Very easy, very simple equation. HL into sigma max or HL into tau max, depending upon the direction of the load. Do you understand this much? This is what? Strength of butt joint. This is the strength of butt joint. Okay. Now, my friend, we will see strength of parallel fillet joint. I told you, fillet joints are of two types, parallel and transverse. What is the difference? Parallel fillet joints means the weld is parallel to the load, and transverse joint is the weld is normal to the load. Okay. So let's consider a parallel fillet joint. Okay. Okay. So I will draw the plates again. Okay. आप लोगों को भी ये ड्राइंग का आदत होना चाहिए, ठीक है? आप लोगों को भी इन ड्राइंग्स की आदत होनी चाहिए. देयर इज अ रीजन व्हाई आई एम नॉट कंसीडरिंग द एक्चुअल इमेजेस इन केस ऑफ जॉइंट. ओके, बिकॉज आई वांट यू टू ड्रॉ दीज इमेजेस, देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. एक्चुअल इमेजेस देख के यहां पे आपको स्ट्रेसेस वगैरह की इतनी क्लैरिटी नहीं मिलेगी, बट दीज इमेजेस विल क्लियर ऑल योर डाउट्स. ओके, आई विल ट्राई टू ड्रॉ द नीट एंड क्लीन इमेजेस. Okay, so in order to distinguish between the plates, I am drawing one plate shorter than the other plate. आप लोगों को इन दोनों प्लेट्स में अंतर समझ में आए, इसलिए मैं दूसरी प्लेट को थोड़ा छोटा बना रहा हूं. ओके, तो ये जरूरी नहीं है हमेशा ऐसा ही हो. आपकी दो प्लेट्स जो है वो सेम साइज की भी हो सकती हैं और ऐसा ओवरलैप कर सकती हैं, लेकिन मैं इसको ऐसा छोटा बना रहा हूं ताकि आपको अंतर समझ में आए कि दोनों प्लेट्स जो है वो किस तरीके से. ओके, सो दीज आर द प्लेट्स. If you draw the side view, then it will look like this. Side से देखने पे, they will look like this. This is the side view. Okay, one plate is kept like this. Okay, and another plate is kept like this. Do you understand? This is the front view, this is the side view. Okay, let's say the load is acting like this. Let's say the load is acting like this. Let's say the load is acting like this. Okay, let's say the load is acting like this. इस व्यू में साइड व्यू में तो दिखेगा नहीं लोड, बिकॉज द लोड विल बी परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस, राइट? साइड व्यू में नहीं दिखेगा. नाउ इन केस ऑफ पैरेलल फिलेट वेल्ड व्हाट डू? वी जॉइन द पैरेलल एजेस. देयर आर फोर एजेस. दिस इज वन एज, हॉरिजॉन्टल वन एज. दिस इज सेकेंड एज. फोर एजेस. व्हाट आर द फोर एजेस? दिस इज वन एज, सेकेंड एज, सॉरी, सेकेंड एज, थर्ड एज, फोर्थ एज. दिस फोर्थ एज विल बी हिडन. ठीक है, ये वाला पूरा दिखाई नहीं देगा क्योंकि ये उसके पीछे रहेगा. ओके, फोर्थ एज विल बी हिडन ना, बिकॉज इफ आई एम कीपिंग द प्लेट्स लाइक दिस. ओके, सो दिस फोर्थ एज विल नॉट बी कंप्लीटली विजिबल ना. ये दूसरे वाले प्लेट का जो दूसरा ये एज है, वर्टिकल एज, इज नॉट कंप्लीटली विजिबल. इट इज हिडन बिहाइंड दिस प्लेट. ओके, नाउ माय फ्रेंड, आउट ऑफ दीज फोर एजेस, two are parallel to the load. This one and two are parallel to the load, and three and four are perpendicular to the load. So here we will weld the parallel edges. Here we will weld the parallel edges like this. Sorry, like this. Here we will weld the parallel edges like this. Okay, this is parallel edge. It is parallel to the applied load. It is parallel to the applied load. And I am assuming both the parallel edges are welded by of the same length. Okay, both these weldings are of same length. That's my assumption. Okay, and my friend, if you look at these welds from the side, it will look like this. From the side, it will look like this. From the sides, it will look like this. It will look like this. Now, do you understand why they are called fillet welds? Can you understand why they are called fillet welds? Look at these welds. Look at these welds. They look like fillets. They look like fillets, right? These welds look like fillets. Look at this. This is known as fillet. This is known as fillet, right? ऐसा थोड़ा curved edge जब रहता है, उसको fillet बोलते हैं, right? क्यों करते हैं? To avoid stress concentration. If the edge is sharp, then there will be stress concentration. So in order to avoid sharp edge, we make a fillet. Okay, so this is no, this looks like fillet. That's why they are known as fillet joint. Do you understand this? Now my friend, let's say this maximum load is P. We can apply maximum P load. Okay, length of these welds is, let's say, equal, L and L. Okay, this is my assumption. Now my friend, here I want you to understand one thing. Here I have welded both these edges. So this is known as double parallel fillet. Okay, why we don't use single parallel fillet? Let's first discuss that. Okay, because in all books you won't see this explanation. In books, you will not see this explanation. Why can we cannot make a welded joint like this? ऐसा करने में क्या दिक्कत है? एक एज को वेल्ड करने में क्या दिक्कत है? पैरेलल फिलेट के केस में ये समझते हैं. ओके, सो लेट्स से दैट द फोर्स इज एक्टिंग लाइक दिस. ओके, लेट्स से दिस इज द फोर्स. ओके, इट इज एक्टिंग लाइक दिस. दिस इज द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स. ओके, दिस इज द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स. ये फोर्स का लाइन ऑफ एक्शन है. ओके, फोर्स जो है वो ऐसा पास हो रहा है, फोर्स का ये लाइन ऑफ एक्शन है. ओके, नाउ माय फ्रेंड, लुक एट द सेंट्रोइड ऑफ द वेल्ड एंड द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स. सेंट्रोइड ऑफ द वेल्ड इज हियर. ओके, वेल्ड का सेंट्रोइड यहां पर है. वेल्ड का सेंट्रोइड जो है सी यहां पर है, एंड लाइन ऑफ एक्शन यहां पर है. So centroid of the weld is at a different place and load is passing through a different point. So there is distance between centroid and force. And whenever this happens, what happens, my friend? Jab bhi aisa hota hai, whenever the force is not passing through the centroid, what will happen? If the force is not passing through the centroid of an area, the force will cause moment. The force will cause moment, couple. So that's why, in order to avoid this moment, what we will do? We will make another weld. We will make another weld like this. We will make another weld like this. We will make another weld like this. तो अब ये जो सेंट्रॉइड है, अब ये जो सेंट्रॉइड है, ये शिफ्ट होके कहां पहुंच जाएगा? Now this centroid will be shifted here because there are both welds. There are two welds. So the centroid will be somewhere here in between, which is passing through the line of action of the force. The force is now passing through the centroid. So there will be no moment. So you have eliminated the moment by using double parallel fillet. Do you understand this point? Note this point somewhere in your notebook. Note this point somewhere in your notebook. Why we use double parallel? Why we don't use single parallel? आप कोई भी किताब खोल के देख लीजिए, वहां आपको किसी भी डायग्राम में सिंगल पैरेलल फिलेट देखने को नहीं मिलेगा. यू विल नेवर सी सिंगल पैरेलल फिलेट जॉइंट इन एनी बुक एंड दे विल नॉट इवन एक्सप्लेन व्हाई देयर इज नो सिंगल पैरेलल फिलेट वेल्ड. सो आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस पॉइंट माय फ्रेंड, आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस ब्यूटिफुल कॉन्सेप्ट. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई वी मेक ऑलवेज डबल पैरेलल फिलेट वेल्ड. व्हाई? बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ सिंगल पैरेलल फिलेट वेल्ड, the line of action of force will not pass through the centroid and there will be moment, there will be additional stresses. So in order to avoid those additional stresses due to moment, we make double parallel fillet weld so that the centroid will be at the center, the force will pass through the center, no couple, no moment. So those additional stresses are now gone. The stresses due to moment are now gone. Do you understand this concept? Do you understand this concept? Very good, my friend. Very good. You have to note all these things down. Okay. Whatever I am giving, whatever additional concepts I am telling, you also have to note these things. Okay. You will have to note these things. So note these things down. Why we use double parallel fillet joint. Okay. So we have a double parallel fillet joint. Look at the side view, my friend. Look at this side view. Okay. I will draw this side view in detail because I want you to understand a beautiful concept. So I will draw this side view in detail. I will draw this side view in detail. Okay. So it looks like this. It looks like this. Okay. Now, my friend, in case of fillet joints, when we model the weld, आपको weld को model करना है, मतलब आपको weld का एक cross section decide करना है. When we model the weld, we always consider the weld to be like a triangle, like this. We always consider the weld to be like a triangle, like this. Okay? ये जो extra material है, this excess material is known as what? This is known as what? Reinforcement. This is reinforcement, which we do not consider. I told you, we do not consider reinforcement while modeling the weld. Okay, जब आप weld को model करते हो, weld का एक dimension लेते हो, तो आप reinforcement consider नहीं करते. Why? Because in most cases, this reinforcement is machined or grinded. So that's why we don't consider this. Okay. So for us, the weld is only this much. Okay. When we calculate the strength, we'll consider only this much. Do you understand this? This is the side view of weld. Okay. Side se dekhne pe aisa dikh raha hai na. So this is the side view of weld. So this part, this excess part is not considered. We will remove it and we will consider that the weld is only this much. Okay, exactly weld aisa hota nahi hai. But if you don't consider this shape, then you will not be able to find the equation of strength. Okay, my friends, understand this thing. Welded joints are very difficult to design. Why? Because the cross section of weld, the dimension of weld are not uniform. एक ही इंसान अगर 10 अलग वेल्डिंग करता है, इफ वन वेल्डर वेल्ड्स 10 डिफरेंट प्लेट्स, इन एवरी केस द डायमेंशन विल बी डिफरेंट, इन एवरी केस द डायमेंशन विल बी डिफरेंट. सो दैट्स व्हाई वेल्डेड जॉइंट्स आर वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू डिजाइन, बिकॉज देयर मॉडलिंग इज नॉट एक्यूरेट. राइट नाउ वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट द जॉइंट इज लाइक अ ट्रायंगल, फ्रॉम साइड व्यू इट इज लाइक अ ट्रायंगल, बट दिस इज नॉट एक्यूरेट, राइट? दिस इज नॉट एन एक्यूरेट मॉडलिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाई व्हाटएवर इक्वेशंस वी डिराइव, they are not exactly true, they are not accurate, they are not accurate. But we need some equation, right? So that we will have some estimate, okay? Kuch estimated value to pata chale, uske liye apne ko ye karna pad raha hai. Otherwise, joints ka, welded joints ka design jo hai, wo mushkil hai, because you cannot accurately model the joint. आप एक्यूरेटली मॉडल नहीं कर सकते हो जॉइंट को कि जॉइंट एग्जैक्टली कैसा दिखेगा, क्योंकि हर केस में वो अलग दिखेगा, हर केस में थिकनेस अलग होगी, राइट? तो इसीलिए यहां जो कुछ भी कर रहे हैं बहुत ज्यादा अजम्पशंस के साथ कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? बहुत ज्यादा अजम्पशंस यूज हो रहे हैं. वी आर यूजिंग अ लॉट ऑफ अजम्पशंस हियर, ओके? सो कीप दिस थिंग इन माइंड, कीप दिस थिंग इन माइंड, ओके? सो माय फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द साइड व्यू ऑफ द वेल्ड. दिस अ डायमेंशन, दिस अ डायमेंशन एंड दिस डायमेंशन, दिस डायमेंशन and this dimension are known as leg of weld. This dimension and this dimension are known as leg of weld, and we assume that they both are equal. Okay, h is what? H is known as leg of weld. H is known as leg of weld. Do you understand this much? Do you understand this much? Very good. Now, my friend, look at the load. The load is passing like this, or from side view, it is passing like this, right? Yes, plate hai agar, to load aisa lag raha hai. To agar aap side view se dekhenge, to side view se aapko dikhega nahi load, because side view se to load aapki taraf ja raha hai na. Side view se to load aapki taraf ja raha hai. So aapko dikhega nahi, theek hai? तो साइड व्यू से द लोड इज एक्टिंग लाइक दिस, परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस प्लेन, परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन, ओके? इन साइड व्यू परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस प्लेन, ओके? नाउ इफ यू कंसीडर एनी प्लेन, इफ यू कंसीडर एनी प्लेन, कंसीडर दिस वर्टिकल प्लेन, कंसीडर दिस वर्टिकल प्लेन, द लोड इज पैरेलल टू दिस वर्टिकल प्लेन. कंसीडर दिस हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन, द लोड इज पैरेलल टू दिस हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन. कंसीडर एन इंक्लाइंड प्लेन, कंसीडर एन इंक्लाइंड प्लेन, the load is also parallel to that inclined plane. The load is parallel to every plane. So on every plane, which stress is developed? Shear stress is developed. Okay, let me write it for you. Let me write it for you. A very important point. A very important point. Load P is parallel to, load P is parallel to every plane of weld. Load P is parallel to every plane of the weld. Okay, every plane of the weld. What are different planes, my friend? There is vertical plane. ठीक है, एक vertical plane. जैसे ये मान लो ये एक plate है, तो ये vertical plane हो गया, ये horizontal plane हो गया. इस plate को मैं ऐसा काटूंगा, incline काटूंगा, तो एक incline plane भी होगा. वैसे ये weld भी है. This weld is also having different planes, right? There is vertical plane, there is horizontal plane, there are inclined planes, and the force is acting like this, so it is parallel to vertical plane, it is also parallel to horizontal plane, it is also parallel to inclined plane. On every plane, the load is parallel. So if the load is parallel, which stress will be developed? Sigma or tau? Sigma or tau? Tau. So on every plane, shear stress is developed. Okay, on every plane, shear stress is developed. okay? Do you understand this point? It is very important to understand, okay? So on every plane, P is acting parallel. So on every plane, tau is developed, okay? Now my friend, on every plane, the load is same, right? P is same on every plane. On this plane also the force is P. On this plane also the force is P. On inclined plane also the force is P. So the value of force is same, but the area of different planes will be different, right? Vertical plane and horizontal plane, these planes have equal area, H into L. Okay, what will be the area of this plane? What will be the area of this plane? Height into length. Okay, let's say this is the vertical plane. So this is the height H and this is the length L. So this area, vertical area, will be H into L. This horizontal area will also be H into L. But the area of the inclined plane will be different. Area of the inclined plane will be different. Let's consider one inclined plane. Okay, let's consider one inclined plane. Let's consider this plane. This is an inclined plane. Okay, let's say that the thickness of this inclined plane, let's say that the thickness of this inclined plane is T dash. Okay, so this value of T dash will be less than H, right? So every plane has different area. Every inclined plane, if you consider another inclined plane, the thickness will be different. So every inclined plane has different area. Now my friend, we need to calculate tau maximum, maximum shear stress, where you are getting maximum stress. So maximum stress will be developed where the area is minimum. Load is same on every plane. Understand this, load is same on every plane, but the area of different planes will be different. If you consider another inclined plane, if you consider another, let's consider another inclined plane. Okay, this plane. The thickness will be different for this plane, na? Thickness will be different for this plane. This will become, let's say, T double dash. So thickness of this plane are different. Area of this plane and this plane are different. Okay. So my friend, on every plane, tau will be different. Tau will be what? Load upon area. So load is same, but area is different. So tau will be different, but we don't need tau on every plane. We just need the maximum value of tau. So where maximum value of tau will be developed? Where the area will be minimum. Okay, where the area will be minimum. So this is another important point that I am going to write. That tau will be maximum on a plane where area is minimum. Okay, tau will be maximum if area is minimum, because the load is same on every plane. P is same on every plane. Okay, so if area is minimum, tau will be maximum. Okay, so we need to find the minimum area. Now area will be thickness into length. For example, here area will be, on vertical plane area will be H into L. On horizontal plane, H into L. On inclined plane, T dash into L. Okay, so L is common, but thickness is different. So we need to find minimum thickness. Okay, we need to find minimum thickness. If thickness is minimum, area will be minimum. Are you getting my point? My final objective is to find tau maximum. Mera final objective hai tau maximum nikalna. Tau maximum nikalne ke liye we need minimum area. For calculating tau max, we need minimum area, and area will be minimum if thickness is minimum. Do you understand this much? Okay, let's find minimum value of T dash. Okay, to isko bhi likhi leta hun. For minimum area T dash should be minimum. Okay, so let's find out what will be the minimum value of T dash. Okay, main logically bhi explain kar sakta hun. I can explain logically what will be the minimum value, but I don't want to explain logically. I first will explain mathematically, tab uske baad logic use karenge. Okay, right now let's mathematically find what will be the minimum value of t dash. So let's say this angle is theta. Let's say this angle is theta. Let's consider this triangle. Let's consider this triangle. Let me draw this triangle. Sorry, हमेशा भूल जाता हूं मैं. Let me draw this triangle. Oh, this. Okay. This length is how much? T dash. Okay, that we need to find. This angle is theta. This is how much? H. Okay, this is how much? H. Okay, this is how much? H. Okay. Now, my friend, this H and this H are same. So, what will be this angle? What will be this angle? This angle will be 45 degree. Okay, this angle will be 45 degree. 45. Okay. तो ये हो गया आपका 45 डिग्री. ओके, अंडरस्टैंड दिस. आई वांट टू कैलकुलेट मिनिमम वैल्यू ऑफ टी डैश. ओके, माय ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू फाइंड मिनिमम टी डैश. सो आई एम कंसीडरिंग दिस ट्रायंगल. ओके, ये ऊपर वाला ट्रायंगल, इस यहां से काट दो और ऊपर वाला ट्रायंगल देखो. ओके, वी नीड टू फाइंड मिनिमम टी डैश. आर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज फाइंडिंग मिनिमम T dash, finding minimum T dash. That is our objective. Okay, finding minimum T dash. वो हमारा ultimate game है. ठीक है? अब now my friend, in this triangle, I can apply triangle law. What is triangle law, my friend? What will be this angle, my friend? What will be this angle? ये angle कितना हो जाएगा? This is 45, this is theta. So this angle will be 180 minus 45 plus theta. Okay. This angle will be equal to 180 minus 45 plus theta. Okay, this angle 180 minus 45 plus theta. Okay, so apply the triangle law here. Okay, t dash divided by t dash ke samne wala angle sine 45 degree. T dash divided by sine 45. T dash के सामने वाला एंगल इक्वल टू H divided by H के सामने वाला एंगल sine of 180 minus 45 plus theta. This is the triangle law. We all know this. Lamy's theorem भी बोल सकते हैं इसको. Lamy's theorem force के केस में हम लोग लगाते थे. T dash divided by sine 45 equals to H divided by sine of this angle. Okay, so from here I can find an equation of T dash. This will become equals to H sine 45 divided by what is sine 180 minus theta? What is sine 180 minus theta? Sine theta. Sine 180 minus theta is sine theta. So it will become sine theta plus 45. Okay, now my friend, what is sine a plus b? What is sine a plus b? Sine a plus b is sine a cos b, sine theta cos 45 plus cos a sine b. So cos theta sine 45, right? Sine a plus b is sine a cos b plus cos a sine b, right? Now my friend, sine 45 cos 45 both are equal, so both will be cancelled. Both will be cancelled. So what you will get? This will be cancelled, na? This sine 45, cos 45, sine 45. Both are equal. Okay. Sine 45, cos 45, all are equal. So they will be cancelled. So what you will get? You will get this. T dash will be equals to. T dash will be equals to. H upon. Sine theta plus cos theta. Okay, this equation is very important because we are going to use this equation in the next derivation also. Okay, in the next derivation also we are going to use this. Okay, so now we have an equation between theta dash, theta and t dash. Okay, when t dash will be minimum, t dash will be minimum if sine theta plus cos theta is maximum, right? If this thing is maximum, t dash will be minimum. So how will we find maximum sine theta plus cos theta? Apply the concept of maxima minima. D by d theta sine theta plus cos theta equals to zero, right? Apply the concept of maxima minima. This is the concept of maxima minima na. Mereko pata karna hai ki sine theta plus cos theta maximum kab hoga. तो मैं क्या करूंगा, साइन थीटा प्लस कॉस थीटा को डिफरेंशिएट करूंगा थीटा के रिस्पेक्ट में, जीरो से इक्वेट कर दूंगा, राइट? जब स्लोप जीरो होता है तो कर्व मैक्सिमम पे पहुंचता है, राइट? कर्व ऐसा जा रहा है, मैक्सिमम पे पहुंचेगा, कर्व मैक्सिमम पे पहुंचेगा, स्लोप जीरो हो जाएगा. सो व्हाट विल बी द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ साइन थीटा कॉस थीटा, व्हाट विल बी डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ कॉस थीटा, माइनस साइन थीटा इक्वल्स टू जीरो. सो हियर थीटा विल बी हाउ मच, 45 डिग्री. So at theta equals to 45 degree, t dash will be minimum and tau will be maximum at theta equals to 45 degree. At theta equals to 45 degree, t dash is minimum. At theta equals to 45 degree, t dash is minimum. This minimum thickness is equal to how much? What is t dash? H upon sine theta plus cos theta. So it will become H upon sine 45 plus cos 45. Okay, calculate karo kitna aa raha hai, calculate karo kitna aa raha hai. This will be equal to how much? H upon sine 45 plus cos 45. 1 upon sine 45 plus cos 45. How much are you getting? 0.707 H. This, my friend, is the minimum thickness. Which is known as throat thickness. This is the minimum thickness, also known as throat thickness. Okay, minimum thickness or throat thickness. Okay, throat क्यों? Minimum cross section यही होता है ना, body में minimum cross section is this throat, so this is known as throat thickness, 0.707 H. Do you understand this? This is the mathematical explanation. Minimum t dash will be 0.707 H at theta equals to 45 degree. Okay, now I can explain this logically also. From this point to this line, what will be the minimum distance from this point? इस line पे अगर आप minimum distance देखोगे तो कब मिलेगा minimum distance? When will you get minimum distance? When this angle will be 90 degree. Perpendicular distance, right? Perpendicular distance is the minimum distance, and if this is 90 and this is 45, then theta will also be 45. Do you understand this logical explanation? From this point to this line, minimum distance will be the perpendicular distance. So this line should be perpendicular to this line. So this will be 90, so this theta will be 45. इस पॉइंट से इस लाइन पे परपेंडिकुलर डालोगे तब मिनिमम डिस्टेंस मिलेगा, और अगर परपेंडिकुलर है ये लाइन तो ये थीटा कितना हुआ, 45. Logically also we can do that, but I wanted you to understand the mathematical explanation. Okay, that's why I derived this equation, complete equation. Okay, आपको पूरा mathematical explanation पता होना चाहिए, तो इसीलिए मैंने ये पूरा equation derive किया. Okay, so t is 0.707 h, minimum t. Okay, so now we can calculate maximum tau. Now we can calculate maximum shear stress. So maximum shear stress. Maximum shear stress. कितने एंगल पे? At theta equals to 45. What will be maximum shear stress? Tau maximum will be equal to P upon minimum area. Right? So it will be T into L. Or you can write P upon 0.707 h into L. Minimum thickness is 0.707 h at theta equals to 45. So from here I can write this P equals to 0.707 h into L into tau maximum. This is the strength. This is the equation of strength. Strength money, maximum load which you can apply without causing failure. Okay? But my friend, here I am considering only one weld. There are two welds. One here. So area will become double. Okay? There are two welds. This equation is for single parallel fillet weld. Okay? This equation is for single parallel weld. If there are double parallel fillet weld, then the area will be double. So what will be your P, my friend? If you multiply this equation by 2, you will get 1.414 HL multiplied by tau max. Just multiply 2. The area will be double. Just multiply 2. Okay. Right now the area is 0.707 HL. But if you multiply 2, it will become 1.414 HL. This is for double parallel fillet. Do you understand this equation, my friend? For single parallel fillet, P equals to 0.707 HL into tau max. And for double parallel fillet, P equals to 1.414 HL into tau max. Okay. So do you understand this? You have to remember this. Single parallel fillet weld and double parallel fillet weld. What will be the equation? So for single parallel fillet weld, it is 0.707 HL tau max, which we never use. Ye to kabhi use nahi hoga. Double parallel hi use hoga hamesha. So 1.414 HL into tau max. ये याद रखना, throat thickness क्या होती है. So at theta equals to 45 degree, the area of weld is minimum. Fillet के केस में area is minimum at the 45 degree. So that's why this area is known as throat area, and its value will be 0.707 h into L. Do you understand this much? Very good if you have understood this point, my friend. Now, my friend, this was the strength of parallel fillet weld, right? Ab hum dekhenge transverse fillet weld. So, transverse fillet weld ke case mein, the weld is perpendicular to the load. Okay? So, again, I will draw the plates. ओके, मैंने बताया था एक प्लेट मैं छोटी ड्रॉ करता हूं ताकि आप लोगों को क्लियर हो दोनों प्लेट के बीच में डिफरेंस. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई ड्रॉ द सेकंड प्लेट शॉर्टर देन द फर्स्ट प्लेट टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द टू प्लेट्स. ओके, द लोड इज एक्टिंग लाइक दिस. the load is acting like this. Okay, now in this case we will weld the perpendicular edges. Okay, so there is one perpendicular edge here and one perpendicular edge which is hidden here. Okay, now my friend, in case of transverse fillet weld, in case of transverse fillet weld, you don't have to weld both the edges. In case of parallel fillet weld, we have to weld both the edges. But in case of transverse fillet weld, you don't have to do that. Why we don't have to do that? Why we don't have to do that? Because in this case, my friend, even if you have a single transverse fillet weld, even if you have a single transverse fillet weld, the line of action of the force will pass through the centroid, right? यहाँ पे देखो, line of action जो है, वो centroid से pass हो रहा है, ये अपना centroid रहेगा, यहाँ पे centroid रहेगा, centroid से pass हो रहा है, तो यहाँ पे आपको ज़रूरत है क्या दूसरे weld की? Do you need the second weld? No, my friend, we don't need the second weld, okay? Because even if there is only one weld, the load is passing through the centroid, so no moment, my friend, no couple, no moment. Do you understand this point? In case of parallel fillet weld, अगर आप एक edge को weld कर दोगे, centroid ऊपर रहेगा और force नीचे रहेगा, तो दोनों weld को कर, दोनों को weld करना पड़ता है. यहाँ we don't need to do that. Even if you weld one edge, the force will pass through the centroid of this edge. No couple or no moment will be developed. Okay. Now, my friend, let's have a look at the side view. Okay. Let's have a look at the side view. इस बार ये वाली side नहीं देखेंगे, दूसरी वाली side देखेंगे. ठीक है? जैसे ये plate है. ये प्लेट है, तो पिछली बार ये वाली साइड देख रहे थे, इस बार मैं आपको ये वाली साइड दिखाना चाहता हूं. ओके, दिस साइड. ओके, दिस साइड. ओके, सो लेट्स ड्रॉ दैट साइड, लेट्स ड्रॉ दैट साइड. सॉरी, तो ये हो गई अपनी एक प्लेट. ठीक है, ये हो गई उसके ऊपर दूसरी प्लेट. ठीक है, इस बार एक अलग साइड से देख रहे हैं इसको. ये आ जा भाई पकड़ में. एक बार, इस बार इसको अब थोड़ी अलग साइड से देख रहे हैं. ओके ओके, फोर्स जो है वो कुछ ऐसा लग रहा है. इस बार इस साइड व्यू में फोर्स भी दिखेगा. फोर्स जो है वो कुछ, सॉरी, फोर्स इज एक्टिंग समथिंग लाइक दिस. Okay, and your weld is here. Your weld, my friend, is here, like this. Your weld is here, like this. Okay, do you understand this? Do you understand this diagram? Plate अभी ऐसी रखी हुई है, मैं इस side से देख रहा हूँ. ये top से बोल दो, side भी नहीं. Look, you can say that you are looking at it from the top. You can say that you are looking at it from the top. Okay, this is the top view. Okay, now my friend, look at the weld in this case. Look at the weld in this case. Again, we will do the same thing. Look at the weld in this case. Again, we will do the same thing. We will not consider the reinforcement. We will not consider this reinforcement. ये जो रीइंफोर्समेंट है इसको हटाओ, मेरे को ये नहीं चाहिए. ओके, सो द वेल्ड विल बी लाइक दिस. ओके, दिस इज एच, दिस इज एच. ओके, कंसिडर एन इंक्लाइन प्लेन. ओके, कंसिडर एन इंक्लाइन प्लेन, कंसिडर एन इंक्लाइन प्लेन लाइक दिस. ओके, कंसिडर एन इंक्लाइन प्लेन लाइक दिस. लेट्स से द एंगल ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन इज थीटा. ओके, ना फोर्स कैसा लग रहा है देखो, फोर्स कैसा लग रहा है देखो, फोर्स इसके ऊपर ऐसा साइड पे लग रहा है, राइट? फोर्स जो है वो कुछ ऐसा साइड पे लग रहा है, कुछ इस तरीके से फोर्स पास हो रहा है. ओके, फोर्स इज एक्टिंग समथिंग लाइक दिस. ओके, कुछ इस तरीके से फोर्स लग रहा है. लेट्स से दिस फोर्स इज पी. ओके, अब इस इंक्लाइंड प्लेन को देखो, इस इंक्लाइंड प्लेन पे फोर्स जो है, इज इट पैरेलल? नो. इज इट परपेंडिकुलर? नो. इंक्लाइन प्लेन को देखो. चलो मैं इंक्लाइन प्लेन से इसको कट कर लेता हूं. ओके, लेट्स कट दिस यूजिंग द इंक्लाइन प्लेन. ओके, इंक्लाइन प्लेन से इसको कट कर लेते हैं. लाइक दिस. ओके, सो दिस फोर्स पी माय फ्रेंड, इज इट पैरेलल टू दिस प्लेन? इज इट पैरेलल टू दिस प्लेन? दिस फोर्स पी इज इट पैरेलल टू दिस प्लेन? दिस प्लेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस प्लेन. इट इज इट पैरेलल टू दिस प्लेन? नो. इज इट परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस प्लेन? नो. सो इन दिस केस व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू रिजॉल्व दिस फोर्स पी इनटू अ नॉर्मल फोर्स एंड अ पैरेलल फोर्स. राइट, वी आर गोइंग टू रिजॉल्व दिस इनटू अ नॉर्मल फोर्स एंड अ पैरेलल फोर्स. ओके, इसको रिजॉल्व करने वाले हैं हम लोग, इसको रिजॉल्व करने वाले हैं इनटू अ नॉर्मल फोर्स एंड अ पैरेलल फोर्स. ओके, लाइक दिस एंड लाइक दिस. ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू रिजॉल्व दिस फोर्स इनटू नॉर्मल एंड पैरेलल कंपोनेंट. ओके, दिस एंगल विल बी थीटा. दिस एंगल, दिस प्लेन इज मेकिंग एंगल थीटा फ्रॉम वर्टिकल. ओके, सो द प्लेन, दिस प्लेन is making angle theta from vertical, so the normal of this plane, this is the normal of this plane, will make angle theta from horizontal. This angle will be theta, so this will be p cos theta and this will be p sin theta. See, this is p cos theta, this is p sin theta. Do you understand this much, my friend? Do you understand this much? On this plane, the inclined plane, the force is neither parallel nor vertical. On inclined plane, the force is neither parallel nor vertical. So what we did, we resolved the force. Okay, we resolved the force into two components, one parallel and one perpendicular. Okay, so the parallel component is p cos theta and the perpendicular component, the parallel component is p sin theta. And perpendicular component is p cos theta. The parallel component is p sin theta. Perpendicular component is p cos theta. Now my friend, what will be the equation of tau at angle theta? What will be the equation of tau at angle theta? At angle theta, tau will be equal to, at angle theta, tau will be equal to, at angle theta, tau will be equal to, what is the parallel force, my friend? What is the parallel force? P sin theta, right? Divided by, what will be the area? What will be the area? What will be the area? Let's say this is T dash. This is T dash. So area will be equal to T dash into L, right? अब यहां पे टी डैश की वैल्यू रख दो. आई टोल्ड यू दैट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द इक्वेशन ऑफ टी डैश. वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द इक्वेशन ऑफ टी डैश. तो यहां पे टी डैश की वैल्यू रख दो. तो टी डैश की वैल्यू क्या है? एच अपॉन साइन थीटा प्लस कॉस थीटा मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एल. तो इसको मैं ऐसा लिख सकता हूं, टाउ इक्वल्स टू पी इंटू साइन थीटा मल्टीप्लाइड बाय साइन थीटा प्लस कॉस थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय एच इंटू एल. व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ टाउ एट एंगल थीटा. दिस इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ टाउ एट एंगल थीटा. ओके, देर विल बी एन इक्वेशन ऑफ सिग्मा ऑल्सो. पी कॉस थीटा अपॉन एरिया. बट वी आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन सिग्मा. वाई? Why we are not interested in sigma? Because in case of welds, they are always weak in shear. Welds are always weak in shear. That's why here we are interested in shear. Do you understand this point? Note this point. We are interested in shear because welds are weak in shear. They are going to fail under shear. That's why I am interested only in tau. I am not interested in sigma. Now I want to find maximum value of tau. Okay, I want to find maximum value of tau. This is the equation of tau with respect to theta. At any angle theta, tau will be this much. Now I want maximum value of tau. Okay, so for maximum value of tau, for maximum value of tau, for maximum value of tau, d by d theta of tau should be 0, right? D by d theta of tau should be 0. तो ये क्या हो जाएगा, d by d theta, p by hl तो constant है, वो तो differentiate नहीं होगा, तो ये हो जाएगा sin theta into sin theta plus cos theta equals to 0. It will be like this, right? D by d theta of tau. Now differentiate it. Differentiate it. Can I consider this like this? U into V. D by d theta of U into V. So what is d by d theta of U into V? U into dV by d theta plus V into du by d theta, right? First into second ka differentiation plus second into first ka differentiation. So this will become sine theta into differentiation of this bracket thing. So it will become cos theta minus sin theta plus second into first ka differentiation. Sin theta plus cos theta into sin theta ka differentiation cos theta equals to 0. So what will you get, my friend? You will get sin theta into cos theta minus sin square theta plus sin theta into cos theta plus cos square theta equals to 0. Okay, now what is sin theta into cos theta? What is sin theta into cos theta? Sin theta into cos theta plus sin theta into cos theta, 2 sin theta cos theta. So I can write it sin 2 theta, sin theta cos theta plus sin theta cos theta. So you get 2 sin theta cos theta means sin 2 theta. Okay, this term sin theta cos theta, sin theta cos theta, sin 2 theta. And what is cos square theta minus sin square theta? What is cos square theta minus sin square theta? It is cos 2 theta equal to 0. Okay, now I can write it like this, sin 2 theta equals to minus of cos 2 theta, yeah, tan 2 theta equals to minus 1. I can write it like this, tan 2 theta equals to minus 1. And when will you get minus 1, my friend? At which value of 10? From here, what you will get? Theta will be equal to, from here you will get theta equals to 67.5 degree. Calculate it. From here you will get theta equals to 67.5 degree. So at 67.5 degree, at 67.5 degree, tau will be maximum. At 67.5 degree, tau will be maximum. Do you understand this? Pichla wala 45 degree pe mila tha, but this time tau will be maximum at 67.5 degree. And what will be tau maximum, my friend? What will be tau maximum? What will be tau maximum? What will be tau maximum? See, put the values in this equation. Put the values in this equation. You will get tau maximum. So, ye kya hai? P by HL sin theta into sin theta plus cos theta. Okay? So, yahan se I can calculate the value of P. Yahan se I can calculate the value of P. What will you get, my friend? What will you get? P will be equal to 0.828 HL into tau maximum. 0.828 HL into tau maximum. 0.828 HL into tau maximum. Are you getting this? Are you getting this? Okay, I have calculated the value of P at 67.5 degree. This is for single parallel fillet weld. This is for single parallel fillet. Sorry, single transverse fillet. This is for single transverse fillet. Okay. for double transverse fillet, its value will become double. So what will be double of 0.828? It will be 1.656. 1.656 HL into tau maximum. So this is for double transverse fillet. This is for double transverse fillet. Now, my friend, I want you to see the equation of P in parallel and transverse fillet. Parallel fillet weld mein kya equation mil raha tha? Parallel fillet weld mein 0.707 aur yahan kitna mil raha hai? 0.828. Baki cheeze same hai. So if you compare P, if you compare P of transverse fillet and P of parallel fillet, what you will get? This will become 0.828 divided by 0.707. Baki cheeze to kat jayengi. So it will be equal to how much? 0.828 by 0.707. Tell me what will you get? It will become 1.17. Right? Means P of transverse fillet weld, strength of transverse fillet weld is greater than strength of parallel fillet weld. Ye yaad rakhna. Strength of transverse fillet weld is greater than strength of parallel fillet weld. Okay, strength of transverse matlab inka load carrying capacity, ye jitna load utha sakte hain. Transverse fillet weld can carry more load compared to parallel fillet weld of the same dimension. HL dono mein same hai, material dono mein same hai. So transverse fillet weld can carry more load compared to parallel fillet weld. How much more? 17% more. How much more? 17% more. This is a very important theory topic, my friend. Very important theory topic. Transverse fillet welds can carry more load compared to parallel fillet weld. Okay. Now, my friend, when it comes to design process, when it comes to design process, we when it comes to design process, we design transverse fillet weld and parallel fillet weld using the same equations. Okay, using the same equations for finding the strength of transverse, for finding the strength of transverse and parallel fillet weld, and parallel fillet weld we use the same equation. We use the same equation. Okay, P equals to 0.707 HL into tau max. अब आप ये सोचोगे कि जब यही करना था तो इतना डेरिवेशन क्यों किया? वो इसलिए ताकि आपको ये कंफर्म हो जाए कि अगर मैं ये इक्वेशन यूज करूंगा तो कहीं मैं कुछ गलत तो नहीं कर रहा हूं. इफ आई एम यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन देन एम आई मेकिंग एनी मिस्टेक? सी, एक्चुअल पी ऑफ ट्रांसवर्स विलेट वेल्ड इज 0.828. I am using lesser value, na? So I am more safe. I am safer. I told you that if you are using less load, means you are safer. आप मान लो 20 किलो का वेट उठा सकते हो. Let's say you can carry 20 kg weight. But if someone ask you how much maximum load you can carry, then you will only tell 15 kg. So you will always be safe. You can carry 20 kg. But you will only carry 15 kg. So you are always safer, right? So if you are carrying less load, you are always safer. You can carry more load, but if you are carrying the less load, you are safer. So instead of using 0.828 HL into tau max, we will use 0.707 HL into tau max, so that our design process will be simple. क्योंकि एक के लिए अलग दूसरे के लिए अलग अलग इक्वेशन यूज नहीं करेंगे. वी विल नॉट यूज सेपरेट सेपरेट इक्वेशंस. ओके, वी विल यूज सिंगल इक्वेशन 0.707 HL into tau max. सो इट विल सिंप्लीफाई आर प्रोसीजर एंड आर डिजाइन विल ऑल्सो बी सेफर. वाई? बिकॉज द एक्चुअल लोड कैरिंग कैपेसिटी इज 0.828 एंड हियर आई एम यूजिंग ओनली 0.707. सो आई एम सेफर माई फ्रेंड. मैं 20 किलो उठा सकता हूं लेकिन मैं 15 के ऊपर उठा ही नहीं रहा हूं, तो मैं तो ज्यादा सेफ हूं ना. मैं 20 किलो तक उठा सकता था लेकिन मैं रिस्क क्यों लू, मैं 15 किलो ही उठाऊंगा. सो आई एम सेफर. सो दैट्स व्हाई माय फ्रेंड, व्हेनेवर यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम ऑफ पैरेलल फिलेट वेल्ड और ट्रांसवर्स फिलेट वेल्ड, यू विल यूज द सेम इक्वेशन. नेवर यूज दिस इक्वेशन अंटिल एंड अनलेस इट इज मेंशन. नेवर यूज इट दिस इक्वेशन. दिस इक्वेशन इज ओनली फॉर योर नॉलेज. दिस इक्वेशन इज फॉर कॉन्सेप्ट. दिस इक्वेशन इज फॉर थ्योरी. बट फॉर न्यूमेरिकल्स we always use this equation, whether it is parallel fillet weld or transverse fillet weld. Use this equation, whether it is parallel fillet or transverse fillet. Use this equation. Do you understand this much? Do you understand this much, my friend? Do you understand this much concept? Very good, very good, my friend. Okay, very good. So this was, my friend, three welded joint. These were three welded joint: parallel fillet, transverse fillet and butt joint. Okay, we have seen three equations for butt joint, for parallel fillet joint and for transverse fillet joint. Okay, gate ke liye itna kafi hai, gate ke liye itna kafi hai. For gate exam this much is enough, my friend. You don't have to see anything else. For engineering services you have to get into detail. For engineering services there are still more topics, but for gate only this much topic is enough from welded joint. Okay, for gate only this much topics are enough for welded joint. If you want to study for engineering services, then there are a few more topics. Okay, there are a few more topics, but we can't cover them in this YouTube channel because, my friend, we have less time, so we can't cover everything. Okay, we can't cover everything. After the syllabus of machine design ends, I am also going to solve some numericals. Okay, I am also going to solve some previous year questions. Okay, we are going to solve some previous year questions based on gate, my friend. Okay, and my friend, I have an announcement for you. From the next lecture onwards, I will be live. From the next lecture onwards, your sessions will be live. Okay, I am trying to get to my studio. So I will take live session. I will try to take live session from the next session. Okay. So from the next session, don't forget to be live at 7:30. We will be live, my friend. And I will directly solve the numericals. I will directly talk to you, my friend, on the live channel. Okay. And I will be in my studio. Okay. There will be a proper setup, proper board. There will be proper lighting, audio, video, everything will be perfect. So you are going to enjoy the lectures from the next time. Okay. And I'm telling you, after the machine design ends, we will solve previous year questions of machine design from gate. Okay. So that will be enough from gate point of view. But if you want to learn more, then my friend, it is not possible here on YouTube. Why I am again and again saying that it is not possible here on YouTube channel, my friend? Why I am again and again saying that? Because, my friend, YouTube is an entertainment platform. YouTube एक entertainment platform है, इस चीज को समझिए. कई बच्चे बोल रहे हैं कि सर पूरा सिलेबस खत्म कीजिए, यहाँ पूरा सिलेबस पढ़ाइए. वो पॉसिबल नहीं है मेरे भाई. क्यों नहीं है? क्योंकि हम वो चीजें आपको यहाँ उतनी अच्छी तरह एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर सकते. टाइम भी बहुत कम होता है. क्यों टाइम कम होता है? अभी अगर मेरे को मशीन डिजाइन पूरा पूरा कवर करना है, इफ आई वॉन्ट टू कंप्लीट द एंटायर सिलेबस ऑफ मशीन डिजाइन हियर, इट विल टेक मोर देन वन मंथ फॉर वन सब्जेक्ट. And if I have to teach every subject, imagine when will your syllabus end? So that's why, my friend, we are not able to cover everything here on YouTube. This is not a dedicated platform for learning. So we need to use a dedicated platform for learning. Come to Unacademy Plus, my friend. Come to Unacademy Plus. Why I am saying to come to Unacademy Plus? Because it is a dedicated channel. It is a dedicated platform for online learning. Once you get on this platform, you will understand how close you will be to your teacher, my friend. You will feel like you are sitting in front of your teacher. That's the level of closeness you will feel on this platform. There are a lot of advantages of Unacademy Plus platform compared to YouTube or any other platform, my friend. You will not see these type of tools, these type of arrangements in any online learning platform, my friend. Okay, so Unacademy Plus platform, this is the India's only online learning platform which I will recommend, my friend. Okay, not just because I am on Unacademy Plus, but my friend, because I'm proud of being on Unacademy Plus. Okay, I'm proud of being a teacher on Unacademy. We all are proud of being a teacher on Unacademy because we feel that we are making a difference. We feel that we are making a difference because we are giving this much content at this rate, my friend, at this cost, compared to classroom coaching. This is nothing, my friend. If you go to any institute, you will pay 3 times, 4 times more compared to Unacademy Plus, and you will only get a few teachers. Here you will get lots of teachers, lots of experienced teachers, lots of top rankers who are teaching you, my friend. You can choose to see the video of any teacher you want. It is up to you, my friend. Okay, there are daily live classes by multiple teachers in English as well as in Hindi. यहाँ language का कोई barrier नहीं है. कुछ classes English में है, कुछ classes Hindi में है. आपको जिसका जो language समझ में आ रहा है उसका attend कीजिए. मैं दोनों language में class लेता हूँ, English में भी और Hindi में भी. I will take the classes in both the languages on Unacademy Plus, in Hindi as well as in English. There will be crash courses, doubt clearing session, हर चौथा lecture doubt clearing session, rank improvement batch, my friend, new batches are starting. New batches are starting for GATE and ESC. Okay, from 1st June. From 1st June. Okay, there is a rank improvement batch also. Rank improvement batch. What is rank improvement batch? In this batch, we are going to solve a lots and lots of questions. Okay, so that's why this batch is for those students who know the basics, but they want to improve their knowledge. Okay, so that is rank improvement batch. You can also join. Everyone can join. There are weekly tests also on Unacademy Plus. And my friend, there are multiple batches and you can join any batch. Multiple batches, you can join any batch. Okay, you can join 2 batches, 3 batches, 4 batches, any batch you want, my friend. It is up to you. There are no limits on the number of batches you can join. And my friend, if you are thinking that whether the online learning is better or not, look at this visualization, look at these diagrams, look at these images. This type of visualization is not possible on whiteboard, my friend. This type of diagrams are not possible on whiteboard. So look at these type of diagrams. You will feel the subject, my friend. You will feel how easily you will understand this subject, my friend. And if you are thinking, what is the difference between YouTube and Unacademy? Why this is better? See, I will give you a very simple example. This is an image of a question sent by a student. A student sent this image to their teacher, to his teacher, and his teacher is explaining the solution, my friend. So this type of facility, is it available on YouTube? Is it available on any platform? No, it is only available on Unacademy Plus. You can send your doubts, as many doubts as you want, to your teacher, and your teacher will give the full solution, my friend. And my friend, there will be live polling and leaderboard. What is leaderboard? Leaderboard will show your ranking among the student. Whenever there is a question, जब भी कोई question होगा, तो कितने student ने answer किया, उसमें से कितने सही लोगों ने answer किया, क्या आपकी rank है, ये आपको दिखेगा. Your timing will be displayed. How quickly you gave the answer, that will be displayed. So see, understand the kind of environment we are creating, the competitive environment we are creating, so that you will be able to practice solving questions, you will be able to improve your timing, you will be able to improve your skills. So this is the difference between YouTube and Unacademy Plus. This facility is not available on any platform, my friend. Okay, so don't waste your time. Go to unacademy.com/plus, pick a goal, GATE and ESE. Choose subscription, which subscription you want, 1 month, 3 month, 6 month. 1 year subscription and 2 year subscription are the best, because per month cost is very less. And if you use this code, you will get 10% off. 1 year subscription will only cost you 22,500 and 2 year will only cost you 27,000 after this code, my friend, after this code. And my friend, a very good news. If you are thinking that this is also very high, then my friend, you can pay the subscription in EMI also. You can pay the subscription in EMI also. There are EMI facilities available, my friend. There are EMI facilities available. You can pay the fees in EMI. One, if you pay the fee in EMI, you will have to pay the EMI of only 1875 rupees per month. 1875 rupees per month you can pay. There is EMI on debit card as well as credit card. Okay.